How's it going, everybody? This is Fernando Paredes, Bucks County's number one fitness and performance coach. As you can see, I'm out and about today on this rainy day in Doylestown. Actually, why don't you take a little quick view of Doylestown? Take a quick panoramic. Cool town, huh? Now, the reason why I'm out and about on a rainy day is because I really want you guys, actually I want to fill you guys in on an interesting new book out there that I think will be very helpful to you. It'll kind of connect the dots on this whole nutrition thing. So let's go into the Doylestown bookshop here and see what it's all about. But you got to be real quiet, all right? Let's go have a seat over here. Guys, let me show you what the deal is here. This is very serious, actually. Take a look at this book. I highly recommend this book, The 9-Inch Diet. Zoom in here. Exposing the Big Conspiracy in America. Folks, let me tell you, I love what this book has to say. It's not a typical diet book where it tells you what to eat or what not to eat. It's all about the psychology. Let me show you the back cover. See what it says there? This isn't a diet book, folks. This is a book about plates and the twisted conspiracy that is making our country fat. Now, don't get me wrong, folks. I'm not one of these crazy conspiracy theorists, right, that thinks that everybody's out to get us. However, in this case, the shoe kind of fits. Let me explain. Number one, let's go back to this back cover. You would think that the guys that wrote this book are nutritionists. They're not. They were advertising executives, highly skilled in psychology, highly skilled in getting us to eat more food. These guys figured out how our brains work and how over the decades, things have changed about how we think about food and therefore how much food we eat. Let me break it down to you. I picked out a few things that I want to highlight. Number one, here we go. Take a look at this. 1963, the average dinner plate was about 9 inches, and you could realistically fit about 810 calories on there. Check it out, folks. Over the years, how it's grown. Two, last count at 2000, it's now at 12 inches. How many calories can you fit on that? A whopping 1,870, folks. A lot of it is not our fault. It's how the whole industry has changed. All right, let me show you something else. Take a look at this. 20 years ago, that was the typical size of a bagel. Come on over. Today, look at the size of a bagel. Is it any wonder people are having problems controlling their portions? They already changed the portions for us without us realizing. Let me show you something else. Oh, you're gonna love this one. Look at this, guys. Take a look at this. 1970, a large cup. Look right next to it. 1980, that same large was now a medium. Now take a look at 2000, that very same size is now a small. Take a look at that again. Same sizes, but depending on the decade, it was a large, medium, and now small. Again, is it any wonder that we're having problems with our food intake? Okay? One last thing I want to show you here. You know, it gets into a lot of great arguments, a lot of really good things that will be very helpful in kind of, as I said, connecting the dots. But then here is a simple six-step formula that they have contained in the book that you can look at. And again, it's not about a diet. It's just about a way of fooling the brain so you can control your portions and get back to the way that people used to eat when they were, for the most part, of normal weight. All right? So hopefully, I gave you guys enough to think about here with this book, The 9-Inch Diet. If you're in Doylestown, definitely come around to the Doylestown Bookshop and pick it up. Alright, if not, if you're not around town, well, I'm sure you can find a good store that carries it. Again, The 9-Inch Diet. Highly recommended, folks. That's about all I have for today. This is Fernando Paredes, Bucks County's #1 fitness and performance coach, signing out. Have a good day.